Hello students, in the last video we saw about the introductory part and the general characteristics of solids, and now in this video we are going to discuss about the classification of solids. We are going to see how the solid substances are classified. Generally, the solid substances are classified into two types, and those types are crystalline solids and the one more is amorphous solids. சரியாமா எப்படி பிரிக்கிறாங்க solids ரெண்டா பிரிக்கிறாங்க one is crystalline solid and the one more is amorphous solids. ஓகேவா crystalline solids க்கு simplest example is sodium chloride. You all might have seen sodium chloride since we use the common salt in our house for cooking purpose. ஓகேவா சோ அப்ப அது எப்படி இருக்கும் நமக்கு தெரியும் ஷைனிங்கா இருக்கும் it is soluble in water everything we know. ஓகேவா ஓகே then amorphous solids here the examples given are glass and rubber. One words la kekkalam which among the following is an example for amorphous solids nu ketanga na what are the examples glass rubber etc. There are so many examples given but here only two examples one is glass and the one more is rubber. Okay, and the crystalline solid is further classified into five types. Those five types are ionic solids, covalent solids, molecular solids, metallic crystals, and atomic solids. This is the further classification of crystalline solids. இதெல்லாம் crystalline solids அஞ்சா பிரிக்கிறாங்க. Those are first one is ionic crystal, second one is covalent crystal, third one is molecular crystal, fourth one is metallic crystal, and finally atomic solids. இது ஒவ்வொன்னு பத்தியும் we'll discuss later elaborately. விளக்கமா பின்னாடி பார்ப்போம். Okay, okay, so this classification flowchart is over and now we are going to discuss the next one, that is what are called as crystalline solids and what are called as amorphous solids. Crystalline solid na enna adu eppadi irukum angulla particles na eppadi arrange a irukum abingiradha paaka porom adhe maadhiri in the same way we'll discuss what is called as amorphous solids, the arrangement of particles in the amorphous solids and their properties. Okay, so first crystalline solid na enna. What is the example I told you? I have told you the example NaCl. Sodium chloride is an example for crystalline solid. It's made up of two different ions, isn't it? Yes. One is Na plus ion and the one more is Cl minus ion. Sodium ion and chloride ion. Okay. So in the picture, here they have used two different colors. One is red color. They have used two different colors. One is red color, another one is blue color. Okay, what example I told you? NaCl. Why two different colors use panirukanga? To differentiate the atoms. If we take the red color as Na means the blue color will be Cl. In order to denote that only, here they have used two different colors. Okay, now the particles, that is Na plus and Cl minus ions, how they are arranged? They are arranged in an ordered manner. One order arranged. One Na plus ion, one Cl minus. Then Na plus, then Cl minus. There is an ordered arrangement of the constituent ions. So this is the essential quality of a crystalline solid. Or a solid crystalline chalano abdina, this condition must be satisfied. The constituent particles should be arranged in an ordered way for a long range. Long range na rambu durathukku idhe mari ordered arrangement a irukkanum. Okay, so this is called as long range order. Appo 2 mark la what is called as long range order nu ketanga na what we have to write, the arrangement of the ions in an ordered manner for a long distance is called as long range order. Okay, vama puriyuda. Okay, so what is crystalline solid? In a solid, if the constituent particles are arranged in an ordered way for a long range, means that is called as crystalline solid. Okay, well, then amorphous solid is different from that of crystalline solid. Here there will be no ordered arrangement of the particles. The particles will be arranged in a random way. Random arrange irukum. Ipo inga white color dots paarenga, they do not follow any ordered arrangement. They are placed in a random way. So such kind of solids are called as amorphous solids. So what is amorphous solids? If the constituent particles are arranged in a random manner, then such kind of solids are called as amorphous solids. Are you able to understand what is crystalline and what is amorphous? Crystalline na enna? If the constituents are arranged in an ordered way, it is called as crystalline solid. If the constituents are arranged in a random way, then it is called as amorphous solid. Okay ma? Okay ma. Now we are going to tabulate the differences between crystalline and amorphous solids. In the table, ungalku paakradhukku seriya visible illa na, while studying you take a textbook and hear my voice so that you can understand. Okay va? Okay, there are 7 differences given. Out of these 7, the last one is examples only given. So the major points are first 6. Okay va? First enna koduthirukanga appadina long range order. The crystalline solids follow what order? Long range order. Whereas the amorphous solids follow short range order. Short range ku da and the particles ellame arrange a irukum. Then second one is a common point. Crystalline solids possess a definite shape whereas amorphous solids do not. Ivangal crystalline solids ku or particular shape irukum but anga particular shape vandu irukadhu. Okay va? And crystalline solids are anisotropy. Idna enna gredha nam rendu paapom. Okay, what is called as anisotropy, we'll see in the next video. Okay, so crystalline solids are anisotropic in nature whereas amorphous solids are isotropic in nature. Okay va? Okay, then crystalline solids are true solids. Ivanga vandu unmayana solids crystallines ellame, but amorphous solids are pseudo solids. Pseudo solids na poliyana solid maadhiriye irukra onnu avladha. Okay, so amorphous solids are pseudo solids, or they are given another name, that is super cooled liquids. Nalla kulura vekkapatta oru neermam. Okay va? That is called as super cooled liquid. That is the fourth difference. Then fifth one is definite heat of fusion. In the particular temperature la idu vandu liquid a maarum, that is fixed. That is called as definite heat of fusion. But inga amorphous solid la apdi or temperature sollave mudiyadhu. Endha range la venalo adhu enna maaralam, melt aagi liquid a maaralam. Okay va? And the crystalline solids possess definite melting point, that is sharp melting point, whereas the amorphous solids possess a range of temperature. ஒரு குறிப்பிட்ட பர்டிகுலராக இந்த டெம்பரேச்சர்லாம் இது மெல்ட் ஆகும்னு சொல்ல முடியாது, வேரி ஆகும் ஒவ்வொரு டைமில், இது ஒவ்வொரு மாதிரி மெல்ட் ஆகும். ஓகேவா? தென் லாஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஃபார் கிறிஸ்டலைன் சாலிட்ஸ். த எக்ஸாம்பிள் டேக்கன் ஆர் NaCl, டைமண்ட் எட்ஸெட்ரா. வெரஸ் ஃபார் அமார்ஃபஸ் சாலிட்ஸ் த எக்ஸாம்பிள்ஸ் ஆர் ரப்பர், பிளாஸ்டிக், கிளாஸ் எட்ஸெட்ரா. ஓகேவா ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், ஆர் ஏபிள் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த டிஃபரன்சஸ் பிட்வீன் கிறிஸ்டலைன் அண்ட் அமார்ஃபஸ் சாலிட்ஸ்? எஸ். Let me repeat for you one time. What's the first difference? Crystalline solids possess long range order, short apachikalam seriya, inga long range order, anga short range order. Inga definite shape, anga no definite shape or irregular shape. Appra inga vandu anisotropy, anga isotropy. Then get true solids, anga pseudo solids are super cool liquids. Definite heat of fusion, no definite heat of fusion. அடுத்தது தே ஹேவ் ஷார்ப் மெல்டிங் பாயிண்ட், வெரஸ் அமார்ஃபஸ் சாலிட்ஸ் டு நாட் பொசஸ் ஷார்ப் மெல்டிங் பாயிண்ட். தென் எக்ஸாம்பிள்ஸ் NaCl, டைமண்ட் எட்ஸெட்ரா. அங்கே பார்த்தோன்னா த எக்ஸாம்பிள்ஸ் ஆர் ரப்பர், பிளாஸ்டிக், கிளாஸ் எட்ஸெட்ரா. ஓகேவாமா? வித் இஸ் த டிஃபரன்சஸ் பிட்வீன் கிறிஸ்டலைன் அண்ட் அமார்ஃபஸ் சாலிட்ஸ் ஓவர். ரிமைனிங் வீல் சி இன் த நெக்ஸ்ட் வீடியோ. ஐ வில் மீட் யூ இன் த நெக்ஸ்ட் வீடியோ வித் த கான்செப்ட் ஆஃப் ஐசோட்ரோபி அண்ட் அனிசோட்ரோபி. நெக்ஸ்ட் வீடியோவில் ஐசோட்ரோபினா என்ன, அனிசோட்ரோபினா என்னன்னு பார்ப்போம். ஏன்னா இங்கே ஒரு டிஃப்ரென்ஸில் பார்த்தோம்ல, பாயிண்ட் நம்பர் 3ல பார்த்தோம்ல, அனிசோட்ரோபி ஐசோட்ரோபி அந்த டேர்ம்ஸ்னால் என்ன, அது எப்படி டிஃபைன் பண்ணணும் அப்படிங்கிறத வீல் சி இன் த நெக்ஸ்ட் வீடியோ. தேங்க்யூ ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ்.